Thanks. Oh, and test results came through for EB.
What, for the last 6 months?
No, just today. They got urgent written on them.
These are for one elderly lady with a sprained ankle.
Poor lady?
No. We'll take it. I get hold of him.
Did you want to post something with that lot?
Yeah, why not? Enough.
Oh, I'll drink to that.
Beer o'clock?
South Island white o'clock.
Picture?
It's a bit tormented. Not the usual jolly dinosaurs chomping through hundreds of innocent victims.
It'll be funny all day.
Harry, come and have a snack.
Did you leave the door open?
No.
Harry, snack time.
Maybe something's going on at school. Did you ring them?
No, did you?
Wasn't a criticism. Has Margaret said anything?
Not to me.
Harry, come on, mate.
He's run away.
He wouldn't. Harry!
I don't like this.
You look upstairs, I'll look outside.
Why are you ordering ESRs and thyroid function tests on a patient with a sprained ankle?
I was being thorough.
This is nuts! You're going to blow our pathology budget if you keep this up.
I just didn't want to miss anything. She's on a heap of meds, she's elderly.
And she's fine. Patch and dispatch is what we do here, not play GP. What is with you today?
Nothing. I'm just trying to do my job.
Are you worried that I'm still carrying a grudge? That if you put a foot wrong, I'm going to go and complain upstairs?
Look, I just don't want to make any more mistakes. I've made too many lately.
We're not talking medical issues anymore, I take it.
You can't always take what people say to you on face value. They don't always tell you what's important. And with people's health at stake, I have to make sure I don't miss a trick.
Okay, look. You've been through some traumatic stuff. You probably should have had counselling, but hey, you know, you're a big tough bloke and you don't do touchy-feely stuff.
I'm fine.
Well, this tells me that you're not. So you listen up. You are smart and, these days, hard-working. You are quite capable as a house surgeon. So, assess, make a judgment call, act on it, and then move on.
Patient with chest pain coming through.
$10 says it's indigestion. I'll do your old lady. Go on.
In the wake of the recent siege at Shortland Street Hospital, the hunger strike is an additional headache for officials at Balmoral Prison. Ringleader Zane Cartonet's hold over fellow inmates is strong, and the message is clear. They will no longer tolerate what they believe to be inhumane conditions. Zane Cartonet, the man with one of New Zealand's most violent crimes...
You've not changed yet. Good. Let's don't worry about the time. Let's have a drink.
I don't want a drink. Now, come on.
Not there?
Has he taken his bike?
No, wherever he is, he's walking.
I'm calling the police.
Well, maybe we should call his friends first.
Oh, Chris, he's only little. He doesn't know where his friends live.
Well, the neighbours then. Maybe he's gone over there.
Yeah, or maybe he's wandering around God knows where. At least the police can be looking for him. We're dialing 111, I suppose. This is just the attitude that's on dumped at school in the first place.
We've been through that. I thought you were picking him up. You thought I was picking him up.
You assumed that. Why? Because I'm less busy? Because my job is less important?
I told you about that interview.
And that's somehow more important than making sure Harry's safe.
Why are you blaming this on me? You're working 60-hour weeks too.
So I'm a negligent mother now, am I? Hi. Harry left this behind.
Maggie!
Harry!
Harry! So, was it indigestion?
Nope.
Damn, I lost my bed. Cardiac.
Nope.
Pneumonia.
Nearly. Pleurisy. At risk for worse. So I've taken baseline bloods, but I should have it packed off to the pharmacy pretty quick.
That's more like it. So, are you over your little speed bump?
Maybe.
Say yes.
Yes.
Okay, now, when did you last have a break? Get out of here. Go on.
Yeah.
TK.
Claudia. Mrs. Bowen.
I've just been to see my son.
How is he?
What the hell do you care?
Of course I care. Why would you say I don't?
After all my family's done for you, I ask for just one thing in return, for you to keep Mackie safe. And now he's in that place, screaming at me to help him, coming off those horrible drugs.
Claudia, I am...
We both knew he was weak, but you just let him go. So much for your honourable new life helping people. If Mackie dies, it'll be your fault.
And join us tonight on One as Pat Kenny hosts The Frontline, bringing today's pressing issues before his panel of guests at 10:15.